Hakimi must start. Conte, do not. Conte, you must start Hakimi. I need to watch that gazelle run down that right side. What is up, everybody, and welcome back to Italian Football TV. You guys are probably surprised right now. You're seeing us drink some wine. You're seeing us in this shot that we haven't filmed a video, Michael and I, by ourselves in a long time. We're always stuck with a bunch of other losers.
Yeah, I know.
And people used to always love these videos of us direct to camera. So we're bringing them back, and this is the first of our prediction and preview series. We're going to go through every Serie A match this round, give our insight, give our predictions, and a little bit of what happened last time. We are going to keep score of how many predictions we get right. We will also have all of the podcast boys send in via text their predictions. We're going to add it up, and every week we will see who is the smartest going forward.
I can already guess that, to be honest. I already know. Who do you think would be last on the list?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just saying he's sitting right next to me. And
okay, I didn't want to be harsh. I was going to say you too, to be honest.
All right, anyway. Guys, let's get into this. Before we do, make sure you like and subscribe if you want more of this content. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe. And if you like this kind of video and you want us going forward, hit that like button. We've got a lot of amazing matches, so let's jump into this right now. First match that we're going to preview, Milan against Spezia. Milan, of course, with Zlatan and without Rebic, coming off of their Europa League win in the most insane penalty shootout I've ever seen in my entire existence on this earth. I have never been more entertained by a penalty shootout.
That was crazy.
It went to 9 penalties, I believe. We had a goalkeeper shooting the ball. We had it coming back and forth.
Hitting the post back and forth. Oh, my God. It went on forever.
Incredible time, but Milan are through to in the Europa League. Milan are 2-4-2 wins against Bologna and Crotone. So they're having a very good season. And Spezia, on the other hand, beat Udinese, which is not really saying much because everybody beats Udinese. And then they lost to Sassuolo, which you can't take too much away because Sassuolo is a good team. There's not too much else to say. I think that this one's going to be pretty straightforward. I got a 3-1 win for AC Milan.
Wow, okay. I mean, Milan, yes, they're undefeated, but without Zlatan, they looked horrible. Against Real Ave, they got lucky. They went through. Even
Mike, the Milan fans completely gone.
Even against Crotone, they weren't even convincing, to be honest. Now they have Rebic out. They have Zlatan now. Leao's not good enough. If Spezia didn't come from Serie B, and they came off their first ever win in Serie A history, I was going to say a draw, but I feel like everyone's going to go crazy on me. I'm going to give this Milan 1-0. They're going to squeeze through.
So
horrible
so
game.
So the only reason you're making the decision is because you're scared of the comments.
Not scared,
okay,
but
let's
I feel
move
like
on to
everyone's
the next
harsh
one.
On me for Milan.
Udinese against Roma. Udinese, one of the most disappointing teams. They went from really, I have family from Udinese, so I'm a little bit biased right now, but they were a great club at one point. I remember the Champions League days. Now they look like a team that's destined to go down to Serie B sooner or later. They lost to Verona and to Spezia. Roma, on the other hand, they do have that automatic loss to Verona because they fielded Diawara, who was listed on the under-22 team. So technicality for that loss. And last week, coming off a 2-2 draw to Juventus, where they were the better team and should have gotten 3 points against Juventus. The only reason they didn't was because Edin Dzeko was not able to convert those chances, in my opinion. Veretout has looked amazing going forward. Spinazzola, in my opinion, still the best left back that's Italian in the Serie A 2, in my opinion. And I think that Roma are going to run rampage with this one. I'm not going to say a high-scoring game, but Roma need this motivation. There's a lot of things going wrong at the club. You know, Petrarca came out saying a lot of things against them. I think a 2-0 win, they are going to be Udinese.
I got that score exactly, Marco.
Nice.
2-0.
You saw my notes and then you copied it.
No, I had it before you, actually, the script. But, Roma, like you were saying, they came off against Juve. They should have won. They were unlucky. Dzeko, I feel like his head's going to be placed on his shoulders this time. I feel like against Juve, he was in La La Land. And Roma are going to get the job done. Poor Udine look horrible. They're going to have a long season. They're really going to be fighting to stay in Serie A this season. Good luck to them. But Roma are taking the 3 points.
Next game, Atalanta against Cagliari. Atalanta mia. My favorite team in Serie A. Every time I watch these guys, I fall more and more in love with them. We all expected that last year they might have dipped off because how can you achieve something better than last year? And this year, they even look better. Gasperini even said himself that we are stronger than last year, which seems absolutely ridiculous to say. They beat Torino, and they're coming off a smashing win against Lazio. 100% deserved against a Lazio that was very strong last season. Papu Gomez continuing the form. Papu Gomez, I love you. This is my love letter to Papu Gomez. I need to slide into those DMs. I love him. He is one of my favorite players in Serie A, and he is ready to run rampage against Cagliari. Cagliari tied Sassuolo and lost to Lazio. They do not have a win in the Serie A this season. They are begging for Raja Nainggolan to come back, and Cagliari, you are not going to win a Serie A game until Nainggolan comes back. This will be a 3-0 win for Atalanta.
Wow, okay. I'm putting high scoring for this one. Cagliari, I pay close attention to them because Lico Yannis is playing there. They don't look as good as last season. Godin is there, which is pretty good, but Raja's probably going to be on his way back there. They'll get... So hopefully the results pick up. But against Atalanta, I'm always putting Atalanta as the winning side. They're going to score 4, but they're also going to concede because Atalanta still don't have that good of a defense. I'm putting 4-1. Atalanta's taking this one.
All right, we still got 3-0 leads. Yeah. Lazio against Inter, one of the best matches of this Serie A weekend. I cannot wait for this. And I would say both with very shaky defenses. Lazio's looked horrible against Atalanta last week. And Inter, since the start of the season, has not looked solid. That back three, especially with Kolarov, they switched it around last week, putting Skriniar and De Vrij, who came back from suspension. But that back three has not looked solid. And I know Inter have 9 goals in their past 2 matches against Fiorentina and against Benevento. But they also have 5 conceded against teams that you might not have expected to score that many goals. Lazio beat Cagliari in their opening match, lost to Atalanta in embarrassing fashion. Not too much for Lazio going forward. Not too many positives for them. For Inter, the depth we know is the key for this team. Even if they go into this match and they're not winning, even if it's tied or they're down in this match in 60th minute, at the flip of a switch with 5 substitutions, which plays into Inter's hands massively this season, this is going to be an Inter win. I see Hakimi absolutely tearing it up in that right wing back spot. Hakimi must start. Conte, do not. Conte, you must start Hakimi. I need to watch that gazelle run down that right side. I have a 4-1 win for Inter.
4-1?
4-1, baby.
Oh, my God.
Quote me.
Inter are fun to watch this season. Even though they do concede, they do play entertaining football. Hakimi, like you said, that guy is amazing. I can't believe I didn't know about him before at Dortmund and Real Madrid, but he's incredible to watch. Lazio, they got hammered by Atalanta. Atalanta, really, they made them look like a Serie B side. So this is going to be closer than I think, though. I think Inter's going to take this, but it's going to be 2-1. Ciro Immobile is going to be on the score sheet, but Conte's getting the 3 points, and they're going to stay undefeated on top of the table.
Juventus versus Napoli should be the best match of the round, at least in my opinion and in our opinion. We are hoping that this one does go forward. We must say we're filming on Friday after the Fiorentina match. We must say we don't know if this is going to go forward. It is scheduled. Genoa had 14 players and staff positive for coronavirus. We know Zielinski, they just found out. They will do more tests. We'll see if this one does get played. As of now, as of the time we're filming, we're going to go with the idea that the match is going to be played. Mm-hmm. Like I said, Zielinski is out with coronavirus. Insigne is also out with an injury. Napoli have actually been, in my opinion, one of the underrated teams of this season. I think a lot of us did not expect them to start the season so well, and they've actually looked really good and revitalized. Like, they look like their energy levels are high and the ideas are there. They beat Parma, they smashed Genoa 6-0. Osimhen. You know Ludovico. I spoke to Ludovico. He calls him Vittorio.
Big V, baby. Big.
Guys, let us know in the comment section how you say his name. Anyway, the guy's a beast. He's been fantastic for Napoli. Mertens going forward too. Koulibaly and Manolas are trying to cement that defensive partnership that we always wanted to see at Napoli. Juventus, on the other hand, we know they won their first match against Sampdoria. Everyone lost their minds a little bit. 2-2 draw in their last match against Roma, which was extremely poor. They were very lucky to beat Roma, and the only reason why Juventus got a point in that match is thanks to Cristiano Ronaldo, who continues to bail them out in the important moments. Juventus is a very tricky team. We don't know which Juventus is going to come out yet. We're still learning. Pirlo doesn't even know the formation that he's going to play. I did watch Juventus's training videos, and I noticed Dybala, Ronaldo, and Morata linking up in the front three, Dybala coming back from injury. So it'll be interesting to see if that is the front three going forward and how they shape up, if it's Dybala behind them, if it's Dybala on the right wing, Ronaldo on the left, and Morata in the middle. Having said that, I'm not too confident with this match. I really want to say that it will end in a tie. That's what my gut was telling me. But I am pushing Juventus to win 3-2 in this match. I think that something is going to come across them and they'll be able to win 3-2 Juventus. Wow, is my prediction.
Okay, that's you got a hunch over there for that one. Zielinski, you said he's out because of COVID. He's been probably one of their best midfielders, probably one of their best players. He was incredible last game. He was linking everything up, so it's going to be a huge loss that he's not going to be playing. But Napoli have a lot of players that they can throw in there. They got Politano that they can put. Lozano's actually playing good. Napoli looking amazing. Like you said, they smashed Genoa. This game...
What's your prediction, Mike?
This game is going to be tough, man.
What's the prediction? You have it written down. You're acting like you're thinking about it on the spot right now.
I think Gattuso is going to replicate what he did in the Coppa Italia final, and they're going to beat Juventus 2-1. They're playing amazing football. They're undefeated. They got the confidence.
Very possible.
And I think they're gonna take the win 2-1.
We're going to run through the last matches. Sassuolo versus Crotone. I have a 3-0 win for Sassuolo.
Sassuolo, Crotone. I have 3-1 for Crotone. First of all, I just want to say Caputo's amazing. He's going to score a goal. He got called up to the Azzurri, so he's going to keep up his goal scoring.
Benevento, Bologna, 1-1.
No, I think Bologna is going to get the goal. Going to get the win. Soriano's been amazing last game. He got 2 goals and assist. And sorry, people. I said it. 1-0.
1-0 for Bologna. For Benevento.
Bologna.
Okay. Parma, Verona, 2-1 win for Verona.
2-1. Verona's taking it. Parma, they're going to be the third loss of the season with their new ownership.
Genoa versus Torino was canceled, obviously, because 14 members. And Fiorentina lost 2-1 to Sampdoria. Guys, that is all the matches. Like and subscribe. And we want to hear. It's easy to criticize us from the comment section.
Exactly.
But we want to put you on the spot. Exactly. Comment every single match, your scores. We'll have the podcast boys, like I said, do this. And we'll have a review every week.
Check them
out. We will continue this content series. Let us know if you enjoy it in the comment section.
Don't delete your comments when you realize you're wrong, because we're not deleting this video. And we'll see. We'll keep a tab for the next video.
Guys, as always, thank you for watching. We'll talk to you soon.
Ciao, guys. Slant. Sip. Your turn. What the f- Wait.